methylene chloride. It has the molecular formula CH2Cl2 and it comes under gem dihalide because the two chlorine atoms are attached to the same carbon atom. This I have discussed in the previous video. The IUPAC name of this compound is dichloro, and only two chlorine, so dichloro, only one carbon, so it is methane, dichloromethane. So we'll go to the preparation. It can be prepared from methane. So you take methane CH4, this on chlorination in the presence of sunlight, it gets substituted, hydrogen gets substituted by chlorine. So you will be getting CH3Cl and there is a removal of hydrogen chloride, and this is, we call it as methyl chloride. And this methyl chloride on further chlorination in the presence of sunlight, you will be getting CH2Cl2 and there is a removal of hydrogen chloride, and this is, we call it as methylene chloride. And this reaction is a free radical substitution reaction. I have discussed this reaction in the earlier video. I will give the link in the description box. You go through it. So it is a free radical substitution reaction and involves four steps. The first step is chain initiation, where radicals will be formed. They get substituted to form methyl chloride, methylene chloride, and you will be getting chloroform carbon tetrachloride. If you want to stop at the stage of methylene chloride, you have to remove the radical by the last step, that is chain termination step. All these things I have discussed in free radical substitution. I will give the link. So this is one method. The second method is from chloroform. So you take chloroform, CH3, do reduction using tin and hydrochloric acid, or you can use nickel hydrogen. So when you do reduction, so one hydrogen is added with this hydrogen to form hydrogen chloride, and this is substituted with CH2Cl2. One chlorine added with hydrogen to form hydrogen chloride, and one hydrogen gets added. So you are getting CH2Cl2, methylene chloride. So these are the two methods of preparing methylene chloride. Trihaloalkanes. These are the compounds containing three halogens, and they are also called as trihalides. Example, CHCl3, where you have three chlorine atoms, it is called as chloroform. And the IUPAC name is trichloromethane. Three chlorine, so trichloro, only one carbon, methane. So trichloromethane. CHI3, where you have three iodine, so it is called as iodoform. So these are the examples. We'll see the preparation and the properties of chloroform. So you take preparation. Chloroform can be prepared from alcohol, aldehyde, ketones, on treatment with bleaching powder. So alcohol, aldehydes, ketones, when they treated with bleaching powder, you will be getting chloroform. But what type of aldehyde and ketones we have to take? So what is the condition of the aldehyde to form chloroform on treatment with bleaching powder? So you take, for example, CH3, C double bond O H. This is acetaldehyde. And this is CHO group, which is aldehyde group. The next carbon is alpha carbon, and it consists of three alpha hydrogen. So here the aldehyde must have 3 alpha hydrogen, only then it can form chloroform on treatment with bleaching powder. Therefore this aldehyde will form chloroform. But if you take this aldehyde, CH3, CH2, C double bond OH, here this is aldehyde group, the functional group. This carbon is alpha carbon, the next carbon is beta carbon. So this alpha carbon consists of only 2 hydrogen. Therefore, it will not form chloroform on treatment with bleaching powder. So the condition is they should have CH3 group next to the functional group. There is 3 alpha hydrogen it should have. If you take ketone, for example, CH3, C double bond O, CH3. So you take acetone. Acetone here, this is the functional group, keto group. This carbon is alpha carbon, this carbon is also alpha carbon, and it consists of 3 alpha hydrogen. So CH3 group is next to that functional group. So 3 alpha hydrogen it has. So it will form chloroform on treatment with bleaching powder. But if you take this ketone, CH3, CH2, C double bond O, CH2, CH3. And this is the functional group, keto group, and this is alpha carbon, and this is also alpha carbon. Here you have only 2 hydrogen, here also only 2 hydrogen. So it will not form chloroform on treatment with bleaching powder. So the condition is it should have CH3 group next to the functional group. That is 3 alpha hydrogen we should have. So this is the case with aldehydes and ketones. What about alcohol? So alcohol on oxidation gives prime aldehyde if it is a primary alcohol. So if it is a primary alcohol which on oxidation gives aldehyde, that aldehyde should have a CH3 group next to functional group, that is alpha hydrogen. Then it can, this alcohol you can take for preparing chloroform. If you take secondary alcohol, the secondary alcohol on oxidation gives a ketone. And this ketone should also have alpha hydrogen. Only then that can be, that alcohol can be used for preparing chloroform. So this is the condition. You can take a primary alcohol, for example, ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol on oxidation gives acetaldehyde. So that ethyl alcohol can be used for preparing chloroform. Now here we are using bleaching powder. So bleaching powder is nothing but CaOCl2. So it is the source of chlorine and alkali. Therefore, it should be used for preparing chloroform, because this bleaching powder on hydrolysis, it will give Cl2 and calcium hydroxide. And this Cl2 acts as an oxidizing agent as well as a chlorinating agent. So when you take ethyl alcohol, CH3, CH2, you write like this, CH2, and then OH. On treatment with chlorine, which is an oxidizing agent, because chlorine on treatment with water, it will form hydrogen chloride, 2 molecules of hydrogen chloride, and nascent oxygen will be formed, which is responsible for oxidation. So this ethyl alcohol will undergo oxidation first with an oxidizing agent, chlorine, which is formed from bleaching powder. So there is a removal of water. Like this it is removed, and you will be getting CH3, C double bond OH. So you are getting acetaldehyde. And this acetaldehyde has alpha hydrogen, CH3 group next to the functional group. So this is the functional group, so next to that you have CH3 group. Therefore, this acetaldehyde on treatment with chlorine, further it gets chlorinated with chlorine, because chlorine is a chlorinating agent. So here the chlorination will take place. That means this 3 hydrogen, they are replaced by 3 chlorine. So you will be getting CCl3, C double bond OH. And then you will be getting 3 hydrogen chloride. So adding totally 6 chlorine atom. So what is the name of this compound? It is called as trichloroacetaldehyde. Otherwise it is called as chloral, or it is called as chloral. And this chloral is having CCl3 and then aldehyde group. So this chloral CCl3. So you take this chloral CCl3CHO on treatment with alkali, which is formed in the first step. So alkali you can write like this CaOH. So you write like this, and this hydrogen and this hydrogen, they will combine with this group and they will form CHCl3. So you have to take 2 molecules of trichloroacetaldehyde, you will be getting 2 molecules of chloroform, CHCl3. Next, you will be getting CaOCHO. So you can write like this, CaOCOH, this 2 times. So this is calcium formate. So you are getting chloroform. So this is the laboratory method of preparing chloroform. So ethyl alcohol on treatment with bleaching powder, first it undergoes oxidation with acetone, with chlorine, which is an oxidizing agent. So there is a removal of water molecule, and this acetaldehyde on further treatment with chlorine undergoes chlorination to form trichloroacetaldehyde, and then it on treatment with calcium hydroxide, it will form chloroform. So this is the preparation of chloroform. Next we will go to the properties. So chemical properties. And this chloroform is mainly used as an anesthetic because it brings about some unconsciousness when it is inhaled, as it attacks the central nervous system. So it is used as an anesthetic. The first property, you can take oxidation. So you take chloroform, CHCl3, structure is like this. So when it undergoes oxidation in air and light, in the presence of light, what happens? This oxygen will combine with this hydrogen and it forms OH here. And you will be getting Cn here, Cn. Now next, what it will happen? This hydrogen will give up its electron and it is removed as H+, and this Cl will take up the electron and it is removed as Cl-. So you will be getting hydrogen chloride. And here this O- will get shifted over here. So you will be getting C double bond O, and you will be having Cl and here Cl. So you are getting COCl2, which is, we call it as carbonyl chloride. And this carbonyl chloride is also called as poison, and which is a highly poisonous substance. So when this chloroform is inhaled with oxygen, it will form a highly poisonous substance called as poison. Due to this, it is not used as an anesthetic nowadays. So this is about oxidation. The next property, we have reduction. So this chloroform CHCl3, when it is reduced in the presence of zinc and hydrochloric acid, you will be getting CH2Cl2 and hydrogen chloride. So this already I have discussed in the methylene chloride preparation. So this is mainly used in the preparation of methylene chloride, this method. So you are adding 2 hydrogen. The next one is treatment with nitric acid. Chloroform with nitric acid. So you take chloroform, structure you take CHCl on treatment with nitric acid. Nitric acid you write like this, OH NO2. So when it is treated, there is a removal of water molecule like this. So this H and this OH, they will combine to form water. So you will be getting CCl3, carbon with 3 chlorine and then NO2. NO2 will form a bond over here. So this is, we call it as chloropicrin. Chloropicrin, otherwise we call it as trichloronitromethane. So it is commonly called as chloropicrin, which is a tear gas, and it is also used as a soil sterilizing agent. And water, you will be getting water. So this is the formation of chloropicrin, which is a tear gas, which is used as a soil sterilizing agent. So chloroform on treatment with nitric acid, you will be getting trichloronitromethane, which is otherwise called as chloropicrin. The next property, we have the reaction with primary amine. So you take a primary amine, that is CH3NH2. This is methylamine on treatment with chloroform, CHCl3, and potassium hydroxide. You take 3 molecules of potassium hydroxide, and there is a removal of potassium chloride, and you will be getting here H3 hydrogen. So 3 OH you have, so they will combine to form 3 molecules of water. So 3 molecules of water, that is hydrogen, here 1 hydrogen, 3 hydrogen, and 3 OH you have, so 3 molecules of water, and 3 potassium chloride will be removed, and remaining what you have is CH3NC, CH3NC. So this is, we call it as methyl isocyanide. So, and this is, we call it as carbylamine reaction, and it's a very important reaction, and this is what we call it as carbylamine reaction, which is a very important reaction, and it is used to test the primary amine. So this is primary amine, and it is used to test primary amine. So we have taken methylamine here. So these are the properties of chloroform. Next we'll go to carbon tetrachloride. So tetrahaloalkane, where you have 4 halogen. Example for this one is, you have CCl4, and it is called as carbon tetrachloride. IUPAC name for this one is tetrachloromethane. So we are going to discuss the preparation and the properties of this carbon tetrachloride. So first you take the preparation. It can be prepared from methane. So you take methane, CH4, on treatment with chlorine in the presence of sunlight. So you'll be getting CCl4 and hydrogen chloride. So you add 4 chlorine, so you'll be getting 4 hydrogen chloride. So this follows through free radical substitution reaction. I have given the link in the description box, you go through it. The second method is from carbon disulfide. So carbon disulfide, right, CS2, on treatment with chlorine in the presence of anhydrous aluminium trichloride, you will be getting CCl4 and sulfur monochloride, S2Cl2, we call it as sulfur monochloride. So these are the 2 methods of preparing carbon tetrachloride. Next we'll go to the properties. So under properties, we have the first one as oxidation. So this carbon tetrachloride on treatment with hot water vapor, it is very hot water vapor, this will form COCl2, that is phosgene, carbon 9 chloride. So it is a highly poisonous gas, it will form and hydrogen chloride. So two molecules of hydrogen chloride it will form. The second one is reduction. You take carbon tetrachloride on reduction using iron and hydrochloric acid. So it undergoes reduction to form CHCl3, chloroform and hydrogen chloride. So these are the properties of carbon tetrachloride. Thank you for watching. Next video we will do chemical bonding.